Hello, beautiful. Good morning. My name is Tarmo and my geocaching name is Metroboy. You have heard this introduction for several times now. Today I am heading to the Hadleigh Castle. And Hadleigh Castle is a very fascinating local ruined castle with quite interesting backstory. So the story starts in 1215 when Hubert de Burgh, the Earl of the Kent, was building this castle for the John II. But John died, new king Henry III came. And as the Hubert de Burgh was not in a good terms with the new king anymore, the castle was taken away and the builder was put in jail. So the castle was there for the royal kingdom as it was taken over by Henry III, but it wasn't widely used. And it was built with bad build quality. So it was getting in a state where it needed lots of renovation works. So it was not well maintained nearly for 100 years. The only good thing about it was that Henry III had water mill built there in 1249. And that was needed for the local economy. Edward III was one of the descendants of the kings. The things looked bright and up on 1249. The things looked better nearly 1 year later when Edward III took keen interest of this castle. And he was there living his last days of his life. And obviously he had the same issues. It was in bad state. So the following kings had very little interest towards this castle. Biggest thing why it was used was that it was like a landmark. When the River Thames estuary was going past this river, then the ships could see the mighty full Britain, you know, with the castles and everything. So 1544, it was bought for £700 by Lord Richard Rich. And it was dismantled 1551 till 1575 as stones. 1814, British painter John Constable was visiting this location, as was doing some drawings. And 1829, a final oil painting was done. And some of these drawings are still in public display. One of them is in London State Gallery, if you are interested to see. And the second biggest turn for the castle was 1891, when William Booth, the founder of the Salvation Army, actually bought the land and this castle together with it. And this location and this castle was used for training new farmers to go overseas in British colonies. There's even a story of this. This castle was maintained early 20th century till mid 20th century for the sheep farming. And there was this funny fellow was keeping sheep in the castle, and there's a photo proof of it. But 1949, Salvation Army finally gave away the castle for the British government, but they still are the big landowners around the castle. And that's one of the reasons why so long time this area here is underdeveloped, and you still have these beautiful views. But as I read from the news, it is soon gonna be changed because money makes the world go around, is it? Even for the Christians. That's an irony, by the way. So let's go and see how this castle looks like. It's quite inclusive, I must say. Like this east tower, southeast tower here. I think this is the most visited location here on this Hadleigh Castle. And I'm actually quite happy that on 1550s this place was not completely sold off for the rocks and building materials. Things like that happens are actually quite... they are understandable. I can understand, obviously, this place was built on a London clay, and London clay is not the best foundation. Like over there, there's a fallen down tower that has just slided off from the mountain. I'll show you in a sec. But I think it's interesting here to, you know, to climb. I've seen some kids climbing here, and if I look over there, show you up there. Over there, underneath that arch, there's some very old graffiti. I mean, graffiti from who knows how many years ago, hundreds years ago. I've seen graffiti on churches where somebody has scratched their initials with the date on the church arches. I was young once. Everybody was once young. I guess many who have visited this tower haven't actually visited this slanted landslide piece of tower that has come down and is heavily slanted. Even I didn't know about it. And this is the thing with the geocaching, that this hobby actually is why I know about it. Because there's an earth cache here, and one of these earth cache questions ask specifically about this slanted tower here, and ask what's the degree of this slanted tower. Even I discovered this one as a surprise. So to answer the question, what's the incline for this one, so southwest tower, then I have an application for that, and it's called inclinometer. And it's actually quite easy to use. So let's see. What is the proposed incline for this one? I don't know how precise this answer is, but it says 110 to 115. So yeah, you can say thank me if you watch this video and you are looking to answer for the earth cache location. There's also quite a few geocaches hidden here in the Hadleigh Park. And 2012 London Olympics, they had the mountain bike competition here along these tracks down there. And as I'm here, there's two geocaches I haven't done yet. One of these ones is Tesco Jarrett's Jiggity Puzzle. Quite tricky one, I must say. And another one is a virtual cache. And the question is, am I gonna do it today? Well, while I'm here, I guess I could go for it. This is the land that belongs to the Salvation Army. You see the houses behind there? That's the land that doesn't belong to the Salvation Army. But all this grassland here and that house over there on top of that hill, that one is the Salvation Army house. And this is the area where way back time they actually teach the people how to plow the land and send those people around the world to the British colonies. And while I am here in the Hadleigh area, I am thinking to get one of those back burners, which is so strange because I'm kind of a little bit involved placing this cache over here, which is amazing cache. And I've sold it and everything, and I cannot get the padlock work. It's hilarious. I'm kind of like the father who cannot get access to the son. Well, I'm not the cache owner, but I am heavily involved setting up this cache. And this location here, well, I'm not gonna say where this location exactly is, but this location here used to have another cache, and it was dedicated to the very last shepherd in the Hadleigh who liked to keep sheep in the Hadleigh Park. And that shepherd was God-fearing person and lived very low and quiet life. He was playing in the brass band and was the member of local community where people looked up to him, heavily involved with the Salvation Army. But yeah, this cache, I actually sent the message to one of my geocaching friends who has found this one. But apparently she's in the Bristol right now, so I hope she will get back to me and I can get access to this cache. And I am happy to report that I am silver medalist of this cache. I was able to get inside. The questions that were asked here were quite ambiguous, and the number that I came up was one of those three that the first finder did get, but because her knowledge about trivia regarding, you know, movies and children program of 1960s is far better than mine, then obviously she had the right answer. And I tried two other combinations before I was able to get inside this one. It's a superb cache, it's a fantastic cache. And I would like to say my big thanks to my friend Tesco Charrett. Thank you, this is a very nice cache. And as you can see, I'm a medal holder.